Hello everyone, welcome back to lesson 8 of module 1 of Elements of Mechanical Engineering. In this lesson, let us solve few numericals on steam and its properties. So in the last lesson, we did learn the concept of formation of steam at constant pressure and what are the properties that can be evaluated from the steam. So using those concepts, so let us solve few numericals on steam and its properties. The first numerical is as below. Determine the density of 1 kg of steam initially at a pressure of 10 bar absolute, having a dryness fraction of 0.78. If 500 kilojoules of heat is added at constant pressure, determine the condition and internal energy of the final state of steam. So take specific heat of saturated steam as 2.1 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. So what they are given in this problem? So 1 kg of steam, so the its initial pressure is 10 bar absolute. So dryness fraction is given, x is 0.78, mass is 1 kg and the pressure is 10 bar. If 500 kilojoules of heat is added at constant pressure, what will be the condition of the steam and what is the internal energy of the final state of the steam? That is what they have asked. So let us see what is being given and what we need to find. So as I said, mass is 1 kg, pressure is 10 bar. So 10 bar pressure need to be converted into pascals. So 10 bar is equal to 10 into 10 to the power of 5 pascals. If I convert that into kilos pascal, so 10 into 10 square kilo pascal, so which is nothing but equal to 1000 kilo pascal. So normally we give pressure in bar, which we need to convert into SI units, which we need to convert into SI units. So 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 pascal. So 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 pascals or 10 to the power of 2 kilopascals. So we can convert from bar to pascals or kilopascals. So x is given as 0.78 and heat added to the system is 500. So after adding 500 kilojoules of it, what is the condition of the steam and what is the internal energy of the final state of the steam is what we are supposed to find. So let us take H1 as the initial enthalpy of the steam. Initial enthalpy means before adding 500 kilojoules. So let H2 be the final enthalpy. Final enthalpy means after adding 500 kilojoules of it. So H2 is nothing but what? Initial enthalpy of steam plus whatever the heat we added. So in our case, H2 is equal to H1. H1 is initial enthalpy plus 500 kilojoules of it. So before adding it, H1 is the heat content of the steam, which is, we call it as enthalpy. And after adding 500 kilojoules of it, so its enthalpy is H2. So H1 is initial and H2 is final enthalpy. So before adding and after adding the heat. So since the pressure is given, so we need to refer pressure table. So steam table, we have two tables. One is a temperature table and the other one is a pressure table, what we discussed in the last lesson. So when the temperature is given, refer the temperature table. If the pressure is given, refer the pressure table. So in this problem, so pressure is given, pressure is at 10 bar. So at 10 bar pressure from the steam table, or which table? Pressure table, note down the values. So what values? The specific volume and the enthalpy. So from the steam table at 10 bar pressure, HF works out to be 762.6 kilojoules per kg. HFG is 2013.6 kilojoules per kg. HF is sensible heat and HFG is latent heat of evaporation. As well as note down the specific volume. So specific volume of steam. So there we have VG and VF. So VF normally it is very less. So therefore we just take VG. Sometimes we just neglect VF value. So VG we have taken 0.19430 meter cube per kg. So note down these values from the steam table. So let us find what is the initial enthalpy H1. So H1 is given by HF plus XHFJ. So as you know that since the value of X is given in the present problem, that means to say initial condition of the steam is what? It is a wet steam, isn't it? So when the value of X is given, so we can clearly say that initially it is a wet steam. Initially means before adding 500 kilojoules of it, what is the condition of steam? It is wet steam. How come we came to conclusion it is a wet steam? Because the value of X is given. If X is 0.78, that means say it is still in the wet state. Okay, so let us find the initial enthalpy of the steam, that is before adding 500 kilojoules. So that H1 we are trying to find, since it is a wet steam, so enthalpy of wet steam, as you know that it is given by HF plus X into HFJ. If I substitute all those things, so enthalpy of wet steam works out to be 2333.2 kilojoules. So this is the initial enthalpy. Initially it is an wet steam having an enthalpy of 2333.2 kilojoules per kg. Now what? We are adding final enthalpy we need to find after adding 500 kilojoules of it. So now let us find what is H2. H2 is the final enthalpy what we have taken. So initial enthalpy is a wet steam of 2332. To that I add 500 kilojoules of heat. So final enthalpy works out to be 2833.2 kilojoules per kg. So after adding the heat, so now I need to check. So initially it was a wet steam before adding it. After adding 500 kilojoules of heat, what happened to the condition of steam? What happened to the condition is whether it is still remaining wet or whether it has become dry saturated steam or whether it has become superheated steam. So that we need to check. So before adding, it is a wet steam because X was being maintained at 0.78. Now after adding 500, it has become 2833. So now check the condition of steam, whether it is still wet or it has become dry saturated or it has become superheated. So how can we check? We can check with comparing this value with that of an HG value. So that's what we will do it. So from the steam table at a 10 bar pressure, HG, note down this value HG. What is this HG? It is the enthalpy of the dry saturated steam. So enthalpy of dry saturated steam is 2776.2 kilojoule and saturation temperature is 179.9 degrees centigrade. So looking at this value, I can come to the conclusion what is the condition of steam after adding final. How can we come to conclusion? So this is the final enthalpy. So cross check the final enthalpy and compare that with the HG value. What is HG value? Enthalpy of dry saturated steam. If the obtained value, if H2 is the final enthalpy, right? If it is lesser than HG, what does it mean? It means it is still a wet steam. If H2 is equal to HG, then it is nothing but dry saturated steam. If H2, that is final enthalpy, is greater than HG, then we can say that it has become a superheated steam. That is how we can decide on the condition of steam. So before adding, it was a wet steam. After adding 500 kilojoules of it has become 2833.2 kilojoules per kg of enthalpy. So now I'll check the condition of steam. So if it has to be a dry saturated steam, it has to maintain an enthalpy of 276. But the given value is what? 2833 after adding 500 kilojoules. So that means to say H2 is greater than HG. When H2 is greater than HG means after adding, the condition of the steam has changed from wet state to superheated state. So that is how I can come to the conclusion. So after adding the heat, so check the final enthalpy with that of the enthalpy of dry saturated steam. So you can clearly come to conclusion that the given steam after adding 500 kilojoules of heat, it has become a superheated steam. Okay, so now let us check what is the superheated temperature, because they've asked what is the condition and they've also asked what is the enthalpy as well as the internal energy. So since it is a superheated steam, for a superheated steam, so we know that enthalpy is given by HG plus CPS of T super minus T saturation. H2 is the enthalpy what we are having at, that is 2833.2. HG value we know, CPS value is given in the problem, that is specific heat of superheated state. Saturation temperature is 179.9, which we have taken from the steam table. So let us substitute and find the superheated temperature. So if I just substitute and check, so the final enthalpy is 2833 and HG value from the table is 2776.2, saturation temperature is 179.9. So from this equation we can find the superheated temperature. So we are heating the steam to 2078. So saturation temperature is 179.9. So beyond 179.2 we have taken and we have heated the steam up to 207 degree centigrade. So superheated temperature is 207 degree centigrade. And from the same thing, we can also find what will be the specific volume of the steam, the superheated steam. So as specific value, volume of the superheated, V super is nothing but V2 we have taken here. So Vg into T super by Ts. That is by Charles law. So if you substitute and find, so superheated steam specific volume works out to be 0.20592 meter cube per kg. So why we are finding all these things means, so we are not asked the volume, we are not asked the superheated temperature, but still we are finding why. We have asked only the condition of steam. What is the condition of steam? After adding heat, it has become superheated. That is the condition of steam. Apart from that, we have asked one more thing. What is the internal energy? So we have asked this one, what is the change in the internal energy, U. Okay, that in order to find that, we have to find all these things. Okay, so what is that internal energy? See, we did come across in the first law of thermodynamics that enthalpy is nothing but equal to internal energy plus the work done. Okay, so whatever the total heat content of the liquid or the substance, so few amount of heat is being consumed by the substance and remaining part of the energy is being used to do the work. How do we measure the work? Pressure into volume gives the work, isn't it? So P multiplied by V gives you the work done, and U is nothing but our internal energy. So this is by first law of thermodynamics. So using the same thing, I have to find this U value. What is that U? U is the internal energy. So U internal energy, U is given by what? U is nothing but equal to H minus PV. Okay, so I wanted H, which is nothing but H2 here in case. I wanted volume. So that the reason I did go for this calculating the specific volume of the steam. In order to find specific volume, I require saturation temperature. So that is the reason we did find the saturation temperature here. Even though we got the superheated steam's enthalpy, we know, but we using that relation, we did find that. Because we want this to find the specific volume, and that specific volume is used to find the work done by the steam, and using that work done, if I subtract the work done from the enthalpy, I will be able to find what is the internal energy possessed by the superheated steam. So this is what they have asked finally, but this cannot be calculated unless if I don't know the value of V2. V2 is nothing but superheated steam's specific volume. So that can be found only if I know the superheated temperature. So that can be found using the enthalpy equation. Okay, so condition of steam is what? After adding 500 kilojoules, initially it's a wet steam. After adding 500 kilojoules of heat, it has become a superheated steam. So that is the condition. And what are the internal energy stored by the superheated steam? It is around 2627.2 kilojoules of heat is being stored as an internal energy by this superheated steam. Okay, so this is the solution for the first numerical. Let's see the next numerical. What is the enthalpy of 5 kg of steam under the following condition? So there are two cases. First one, they are given the pressure and what is the dryness fraction. In the second case, they are given the pressure as well as the temperature. So let us check what is the condition of the steam in each case. So what is the enthalpy of 5 kg of steam under the following conditions? The first one is pressure is 0.8 bar having a dryness fraction of 90%, that is x is 0.9, that is the first case. Second case, 20 bar absolute pressure pressure is given and the temperature is also given, 300 degrees centigrade. Don't take this as saturation temperature. No, this is not saturation temperature. Since the pressure is given, so given temperature is the temperature of the steam at the present condition. That's all. So that is nothing to do with saturation temperature. Saturation temperature, you have to find at 20 bar what will be the saturation pressure. So in both the cases, they have given the pressure. So you have to refer the pressure table to note down the values. So take specific heat of the superheated system, that is CPS value. They are given as 2.25 kilojoules per kg. So let us go for the first case. As I said, pressure is 0.8 bar, dryness fraction X is 0.9. Okay, since they have given dryness fraction X value, so I can clearly say that the first case is a wet steam. In the first case, it is a wet steam. So therefore, I can find the enthalpy of the wet steam. So what is the enthalpy of wet steam? It is nothing but given by HF plus XHFG. So if I substitute this, I will be getting what is the enthalpy of wet steam per kg of the steam. So substitute here. So before substituting, note down the values from the steam table at 0.8 bar. So 0.8 bar means 0.8 into 10 to the power of 5 kilopascal. While substituting, you should substitute in kilopascal if you are trying to find the work done and all those things. But here in that case, we don't require, we just require enthalpy here. So at 0.8 bar from the data and with the steam table, note down the value of HF and note down the value of HFD. So HF works out to be 391.7 and HFG works out to be 2274.1. If I multiply this and find, you will be getting the enthalpy per kg. But here we have given it is not 1 kg of steam, it is 5 kg of steam. So if enthalpy per kg is so much, so for a total of 5 kg, how much? Just multiply it by the mass. So that's the reason for m kgs. But here in this case, 5 kgs. If I just substitute, I'll get what is the heat content or the enthalpy per unit kg or per kg. So if you multiply it by 5, I'll get the total enthalpy of wet steam. So total enthalpy of wet steam is 12,191.95 kilojoules. See the unit. It is the total enthalpy possessed by 5 kg of steam. Okay. So we have multiplied it by mass. So therefore, H has to be written only in kilojoules because we have multiplied by mass. If it is per unit kg, it is kilojoules per kg is the unit of enthalpy. Since we have multiplied it by mass, so total heat content or the enthalpy possessed by 5 kg of steam is 12,191.95 kilojoules. Let's go for the second case. What is the second case? Pressure is 20 bar and the temperature of the steam is 200 degrees centigrade. Sorry, 300 degrees centigrade. So from steam tables, pressure tables, note down the saturation temperature. So at 20 bar pressure, saturation temperature works out to be 212.4 degrees centigrade. And what is the given temperature of the steam? 300 degrees centigrade. So if I just compare the temperature of the given steam, which is 300 degree, with that of saturation temperature, we can clearly come to the conclusion that the steam at present is superheated steam, isn't it? If the temperature is greater than saturation temperature, then it is what? If the given temperature T, if it is greater than saturation temperature, then it is a superheated steam. If the given temperature is less than saturation temperature, then definitely it is a wet steam. If the given temperature is equal to saturation temperature, then definitely it is a dry saturated steam. But in the present case, the given temperature is 300 degrees centigrade, but the saturation temperature from the table works out to be 212.4. Therefore, the given temperature is more than the saturation temperature. So the condition of steam is what? It is a superheated steam. It's a superheated steam. So from the steam table, you can note down the value of HG also. HG works out to be 2797 kilojoules per kg. So enthalpy of superheated steam is given by HG. Enthalpy of superheated steam is given by HG plus CPS. CPS is specific heat of superheated steam of superheated temperature minus saturation temperature. So substitute the values. Hg we have noted down from the steam table. Cps is given as 2.25 in the problem itself. So superheated temperature is 300. The given steam is what? Superheated. So this 300 is nothing but your superheated temperature. So 300 minus 212.4. So enthalpy of this works out to be 14,971. See, if I don't multiply it by 5, it is nothing but the enthalpy possessed by 1 kg of superheated steam. Since we are multiplying it by mass, previously also we did the same thing. So since the given mass of steam is 5 kgs, I'll be multiplying it by 5. So it is the 14,971.5 kilojoules of heat is the total heat or the total enthalpy possessed by the superheated steam. Got it? Let's move on to the next problem. Find the internal energy of 2.5 kg of steam at 20 bar when there are two cases. It is wet and its dryness fraction is 0.9. Second case, it is superheated to 350 degrees centigrade. Take specific heat of steam as 2.3 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. It is very much similar to the previous thing. So mass is given, 5 kgs. Pressure is given, 20 bar. Two cases. First case is what? It is wet. They have said the condition, they have already said it is a wet steam and its dryness fraction is 0.9. So they have mentioned the condition. What you are supposed to calculate? You are supposed to calculate the internal energy U. In order to find internal energy U, U is given by what? H minus PV. H is the total enthalpy minus P into V. That means to say, before finding U, I need to note down the value of H. I need to find the work done PV also. In order to multiply P with volume, so I need to find even the specific volume. So note down the enthalpy and work out the enthalpy of the first case as well as second case, as well as the specific volume in each case, and then find the internal energy. So very much similar to what we did with respect to the first numericals. So let us solve one by one. The first case, it is purely a wet steam. Second case, it is a superheated steam. They have mentioned that it is superheated to 350 degrees. So the condition is mentioned that it is a superheated steam and the given temperature is superheated temperature. So let us solve one by one. So given mass is 2.5 kg, pressure is 20 bar and steam is a wet steam. So X is 0.9. So from steam table, using pressure table, at a 20 bar pressure, note down the value of HF. Note down the value of HFG. Since it is a wet steam, enthalpy of wet steam is given by HF plus X into HFG. So substitute the value of HF plus X into HFG values and you will come to know what is the enthalpy of that. So enthalpy works out to be 2608.33. And from the same steam table, also note down the volume, specific volume of the wet steam at 20 bar pressure, which works out to be 0.09955 meter cube per kg. Why we are using specific volume? Because we need to find the work done and this work done need to be subtracted from the enthalpy to get the internal energy. Okay, so this is the specific volume of dry saturated steam, what we noted down from the steam table. But what is the present condition of steam? It is a wet steam. So therefore, I need to find what is the specific volume of wet steam. So specific volume of wet steam is given by X into Vg plus 1 minus X into Vf. So normally Vf value compared to Vg value is very, very less. Therefore, normally we neglect this particular product. Wetness fraction multiplied by specific volume of the fluid. So if you just refer the table, the volume occupied by the water particles is very, very less compared to what volume occupied by the steam particle. Therefore, we neglect this and we just take the enthalpy of wet steam as, specific volume of wet steam as X into Vg. That's what we have done. So this is the specific volume of the wet steam. What we noted from the table is what? Specific volume of the dry saturated steam. But in the present case, it is not a dry saturated steam, it is a wet steam. So therefore, we need to find the specific volume of wet steam. So that is given by X into Vg. So that works out to be 0.0 0.89595 meter cube per kg. So specific internal energy, as I said, U is given by H minus PV. So H, it worked out to be 2608, right? This is H value and this is V value, and the pressure is how much? 20 bar. So substitute that, you will come to know what is the internal energy. So U, H minus PV, H is this 2608 and pressure is 20 bar, so which we have converted into pascals, kilopascals. Okay, so 20 multiplied by 100 gives you in terms of kilopascal. Don't substitute in bar here, especially when calculating work done. So it has to be substituted in kilopascals. Okay, 20 bar is 2000 kilopascals multiplied by the specific volume, so it works out to be 2429.14 kilojoules per kg. Whatever we just found, whether it is H value or the specific volume or this internal energy, all we have calculated per unit mass, that is per kg. But the given mass is how much? 2.5 kg. So therefore, multiply it by the mass. Okay, so then if I multiply it by mass, it works out to be 6072.85 kilojoules of heat. That is the internal energy in case of the first condition where it is a wet steam. If I move on to the second condition, the condition is mentioned that it is a superheated steam. So therefore, the superheated temperature is 350 degrees centigrade. Okay, the pressure is 20 bar only. So at 20 bar, note down the saturation temperature, what are the HG value and what is the VG value. So we'll repeat the same process in case of the second case also. Since it is a superheated steam, so find the enthalpy of superheated steam. So enthalpy of superheated steam is given by HG plus CPS of T super minus TS. So we have HG value, we have CPS value is given in the problem. Okay, so we have this temperatures also. So substitute that, you will come to know 3113.68 is the kilojoules of heat possessed by the superheated. This is the enthalpy. So per kg only we are still calculating. Finally, we'll go for 2.5 kg. So on the same lines, find the specific volume of superheated steam. So specific volume of superheated steam is given by Charles' law. So V super is given by Vg into ratio of superheated temperature to saturation temperature. Okay, so one thing you should bear in mind, when you are going for this ratio, both saturation temperature as well as superheated temperature has to be substituted in absolute Kelvin. Okay, so 350 plus 273, 212.4 plus 273, that need to be substituted. And if I substitute here, so volume, specific volume of superheated steam works out to be 0.12777 meter cube per kg. So we have enthalpy, we have volume. So now I can find the internal energy of this superheated steam. So H super minus P into V super. So H super is 3130.68. So pressure is 20 bar, that is 2000 kilopascal. And what is the volume? Just now we found 1.12777. So enthalpy of, internal energy possessed by this superheated steam is 2858.13 kilojoules per kg. Since the mass is given as 2.5 kg, so total internal energy possessed by this 2.5 kg of steam is 7145.34 kilojoules. Got it? Okay. Let us solve one more problem. Steam is at 9 bar pressure and dryness fraction is 0.98. P is given, X is given. Find the quality and temperature of steam. What they have asked? Quality. Quality means you have to decide whether it's a wet steam or dry saturated steam or superheated steam. And you have to also find what is the temperature. When? First case, the steam loses 50 kilojoules per kg of heat at constant pressure. Second case, when the steam receives 150 kilojoules per kg at constant pressure. Two cases. If I add 150 kilojoules, what is the condition of the steam and temperature? If the steam loses 50 kilojoules per kg of heat, then what is the quality or the condition and the temperature of steam? So at 9 bar pressure, from the steam table, pressure table, using pressure table, note down the properties. What properties? Enthalpy as well as saturation temperature. HF is 742, HFG is 2029, HG is 2772.1, and saturation temperature works out to be 175.4. Okay, so given X is 0.91, you have taken X1 just to check after adding it whether it still remains as a wet steam or not. If it still remains as a wet steam, then we have to find what is the change in the dryness fraction. So initially we'll take it X as X1.98. So let us find what is the initial enthalpy. Initial enthalpy means before it losing the heat or before we add. So we have to find that initial enthalpy. As of at 9 bar having a dryness fraction of 0.98, what is the enthalpy possessed by the steam? That is what we are trying to find here. Initial enthalpy of the steam before it loses 50 kilojoules or it receives 150 kilojoules. So that is what we are trying to find. Initial enthalpy is given by H1. So initial condition is having a wet dryness fraction of 0.98. So that we have taken it as X1. So that is given by HF plus X1 into HFG. So which works out to be 2731.5. So this is the initial enthalpy of steam. So now let us go one by one. First case is what? When the steam loses 50 kilojoules per kg of heat at constant pressure. So what is the initial enthalpy? Initial enthalpy is 2731.51. So now it is losing 50 kilojoules. Let us subtract the 50 kilojoules. So H2, let us take it as final enthalpy after losing 50 kilojoules per kg of it. Okay, so 2731.51 minus 50, it works out to be 2681.51. So before losing it was a wet steam. Even after losing it, it will be still be a wet steam, isn't it? Isn't it? Because the enthalpy has dropped. Enthalpy has dropped means it is still in wet steam. So you can, how do you check that? You can check this with HG value. Since the final enthalpy is lesser than HG, so what is HG value that we have noted down here? HG is what? 2772.1. So that we discussed. If the condition, if the enthalpy is lesser than HG, wet steam. Equal to HG, dry saturated. Greater than HG, it is an superheated steam. So in the present case, it is lesser than HG. So this means to say the steam is a wet steam. Okay. So what is the enthalpy of that steam? We know that 2681.51 is the condition or the enthalpy of the wet steam after losing 15. So this is known. This is also known. This also, from that I can find what will be the dryness fraction of that wet steam after losing 50 kilojoules of it. So that I can find here. So condition of steam. So substitute 2681.51 is the enthalpy after losing it. So this we know from the table. This also we know from the table. So substitute and find the dryness fraction. So before losing, it had a dryness fraction of 0.98. After losing it, its dryness fraction is 9.95. Okay, so 0.98 dryness has been reduced to 0.95. Okay, so this is with respect to the first case. Second case is what? It receives 150 kilojoules per kg of heat. It is receiving. So what is the initial enthalpy? H1 we found it to be 2731.51. To that I'll add 150 kilojoules. So 2781.51. So in the present case, it is greater than HG value. HG is 2771, I guess. Yes. 2772.1. So H2 is how much? 2881.5, and definitely greater than HG value. So when it is greater than HG value, what is the condition of steam? It is a superheated steam. Okay, so when it is a superheated steam, so we can find what is the superheated temperature. If it is a wet steam, we are finding the quality of wet steam, that is the dryness fraction. If it is a superheated steam, what can we find? We can find the superheated temperature, isn't it? Nothing can be found in case of HG. Isn't it? If it is a saturated steam, X is equal to 1. Temperature is, that is nothing but equal to what? Saturation temperature. Only if it is a wet steam, we'll try to find what is the new value of X. If it is a superheated steam, we'll try to find what is the superheated temperature. So HG is known. H2, the present condition or the final enthalpy after receiving 150 kilojoules of heat is known. CPS value is given in this problem. saturation temperature is known, so you can find the superheated steam. In the second case, after receiving 150 kilojoules per kg of heat, it has become a superheated steam, and the temperature of this superheated steam is 227.5 degree centigrade. Okay, so this is the solution for the given problem. Let us see one more numerical. 2 kg of wet steam is heated at constant pressure of 2 bar until its temperature increases to 150 degree centigrade. The heat transferred is 2100 kilojoules. Find the initial dryness fraction of steam and take the specific heat of steam as 2.1 kilojoules per kg. The properties of steam at 2 bar pressure are given below. Even the properties also they are given in the problem. Okay, so if they are not given, we can note down from the steam table. So mass is how much? 2 kg. Pressure is 2 bar. 2 bar means 2000 kilopascal. Okay. And what is the temperature? So after adding heat, the temperature rises to 150 degrees centigrade. And what are the heat transfer total? 2100. Heat added is how much? 2100 kilojoules. So from the steam table at 2 bar pressure, note down the values of TS, HG and HF. Okay. So if I just note down that, so saturation temperature works out to be 120.3. HFG value, anyway, from HG value, you know, 2706.5 taken from the table. HF is also taken from the table. HFG we can find. And anyway, this is available even from the table also. So what is the temperature? The steam is maintaining a temperature of how much? 150 degree centigrade. But at 2 bar pressure, what is the temperature, saturation temperature? 120.3. So the given temperature of the steam is 150, but the saturation temperature is 120.3. So from comparing this temperature, I can say that if T is greater than saturation temperature, then obviously the present condition of the steam is superheated steam, isn't it? So it is a superheated steam. So when it is a superheated steam, let us find the enthalpy of the superheated steam. H2 is given by Hg plus Cps of T super minus T. So Cps value is given. Hg we have taken from the table, 150 minus 273. Anyway, this also you can substitute in Kelvin since it is a difference. So adding plus 273 to plus 273 on either side, it doesn't make a difference. Okay, if it's a difference, you can directly substitute. If it's a ratio, you need to add plus 273 for both the temperature. It has to be taken in absolute. Here also you can take it in absolute, but it doesn't make any difference. So enthalpy of superheated steam works out to be 2762.2 kilojoules per kg. Okay, so that was fine. So what is the heat added? Heat added is what? Total heat added is 2100 kilojoules. But we are trying to find everything for per kg. So what is the total mass of the steam? We have taken 2 kg. So for 2 kg, 2100 kilojoules of heat is added. So per kg, half of that, right? So 1050 is the heat added per kg. Total added is 2100. So if I convert that heat added per kg of steam, it works out to be 1050 kilojoules per kg. So what is the final enthalpy? So final enthalpy H2 is given by the initial enthalpy plus 1050. So final enthalpy is known. So what is the final enthalpy? It is nothing but our superheated steam, 2762.0. Before adding, I am trying to find what is the condition of steam before we add this 1050 kgs of heat per kg. Got it? After adding it, it is 150 degree centigrade, it is superheated steam. But before I could add this 2100 kilojoules of heat to 2 kg of steam, what was the initial condition of the steam? So that I am trying to find. So I did add 1050 kilojoules of heat per kg. Okay, everything I am trying to calculate per kg. So final enthalpy is H2 plus is equal to what? H1 plus 1050. After adding 1050 only, I got this as a superheated steam. But I am trying to find what is the condition of the initial before adding heat. So therefore, initial enthalpy is given by H2 minus 1050. So initial enthalpy of steam works out to be 1719.2 kilo. That means before I could add 2100 kilojoules of heat for 2 kg of steam or 1050 of kilojoules of heat per kg of steam, the enthalpy that was maintained by steam was 1719.2. If I just compare, H1 is lesser than Hg. If H1 is lesser than Hg, that means to say initially it was a wet steam. Initially it was a wet steam, then we added 1050 kilojoules of heat per kg or in total 2100 kilojoules for 2 kg. Then it became a superheated steam, that we got to know. So now I'm trying to find the initial condition. So initially it was a wet steam. Initially if it was a wet steam, what is the dryness fraction of that? That I can find. So H1 is given by HF plus X1 into HFG. So this is the initial enthalpy before 2100 kilojoules of heat were added. So HF plus X1 into HFG. So these two values we can note down from the table. So initial dryness, it was 0.5516. So before adding it, so it was a wet steam. Okay, so see here, 2 kg of wet steam, pressure was 2 bar, heat transferred is 2100. After transferring 2100 kilojoules of heat for 2 kg, its temperature rose to 150 degrees centigrade. So comparing this, we came to conclude that the final state of the steam is an superheated steam. So what we have asked, find the initial dryness fraction. So initially it was an wet steam, so that we could find here. So subtract the amount of heat added from the final enthalpy, you will come to know the, what is the initial enthalpy of steam. So initially it was a wet steam, and this is the enthalpy of the wet steam. So from the enthalpy of wet steam, I can find what is the dryness fraction of the wet steam before that heat was added. Okay, so this is the solution for the given numerical. So like this, we can solve various numericals, so pertaining to finding the enthalpy of wet steam or the condition of the wet steam or the dryness fraction of the wet steam. So if the heat is added, if the heat is lost, what is the change in the condition of steam and what are their corresponding other properties. If it's a wet steam, we try to find the dryness fraction X. If it's a superheated steam, we'll try to find the superheated temperature. Okay, so these are the few numericals which we have solved using the concept of steam formation at constant pressure, as well as some of the properties connected with the formation of steam. So with this, we have come to the end of module 1. Let me summarize. So what all we covered under module 1. So module 1, basically we took 8 lessons to complete this module 1. In the first 3 lessons, we did complete the sources of energy and its conversion. So what do you mean by energy? Classification of energy. So basically it was classified as conventional, non-conventional. What are the conventional sources we discussed, like fossil fuels and hydro source? What are the non-conventional energy sources we discussed? There's nothing but solar energy, wind energy, nuclear power plant, biogas, biomass, etc. Okay, so all those things were covered under the first 3 lessons. Next 3 lessons, we did cover the concept of thermodynamics. So where we did understand the concept of thermodynamics, especially what you mean by a system, what you mean by a cycle, and we did discuss the 4 laws of thermodynamics: zeroth law, first law, second law, and the third law. And we did solve few numericals applying the first and the second law of thermodynamics. In formation of steam and its properties, we did take 2 lessons on that. In the first lesson, we did discuss the concept of formation of steam at constant pressure and what are the properties we look for in a steam. And in the last lesson, we did discuss few numericals on the formation of steam and its properties. Hope you have learned a lot from this module 1. Thank you.